Thank you, Dr. Vinod. Everybody, attention. I'm going to demonstrate the first time the live cataract surgery with a femto-assisted laser cataract surgery, called as a FLAX or LAX or whatever it is. And now I'm in my femto room, which is a little different from the regular operating room, because the femto laser head will not take the fumigation, formalin fumigation easily. So we just kept the femto laser machine, the catalyst by Johnson & Johnson in a adjacent room, which is a clean room. It is not essentially a sterile room. Am I audible there?
Yes, sir.
You're audible, sir.
Please. Now, I'll just explain a little bit about the machine and the technology. As you all know, we have been using the lasers quite some time in ophthalmology. This femtosecond laser is the most advanced one. We have been using this neodymium YAG laser for our capsulotomies. We all know that it acts by the photo disruption. And this femtosecond laser cataract surgery, you know, the wavelength is around 10 to, the duration of the pulse is around 10 to the power of minus 15. The neodymium YAG laser, I'm sorry, I'm audible there?
Yeah, sir, you're audible, sir.
Please. Yeah, the neodymium YAG laser works at the 10 to the power of minus 9, and this femtosecond laser, 10 to the power of minus 15. That is called as femto, it's a Danish word. Femto is a Danish word. So what happens is, the laser, we all know, the laser, whenever exposed to the tissue in the lenticular matter or the capsule or the cornea, it creates a sort of plasma there. The tissue gets hydrolyzed because of this light energy there, and then the plasma expands a little further, and then it creates a plane there, and then cavitation bubbles releases there, and thereby a plane is created, the tissue plane is created. The beauty of this femto laser is it will not generate any thermal effect as in the case of phacoemulsification, because the cavitation energy or the cavitation bubble or the wave, whatever it is, because of the plasma, it confines only up to the 100 microns, which is very small, little tiny. And this, the machine which we are working with now is a catalyst run by Johnson & Johnson. It has got four steps, the plan of the treatment. The advantage of this femto laser cataract surgery is we can plan the cataract surgery, all the steps of our cataract surgery, even before the patient is taken to the operating room. So we'll feed the data into the monitor here. It had we have plan of the treatment. And that first is we enter the geographical data of the patient, the name, the age of death of the MRD and all, and we can always fix up either left eye or the right eye. And then what are the steps you are going to do for that particular patient? In these cases, the first one is the capsulotomy, the second one is fragmentation and the segmentation of the nucleus proper, and the third one is archaic incisions, and the fourth one is the corneal incision, which you want to make it or not. So now, next. So the next step is this is a capsulotomy. We all know the advantage of this capsulotomy with a femto laser assisted is the size of the capsulotomy you can titrate, and the shape of the capsulotomy is perfectly circular. So there are some studies saying that the circularity of the capsulotomy will help you get a better centration in case of a premium evals like the toric evals and the multifocal evals and the symphony evals all alike. So the size of the capsulotomy and the centering of the capsulotomy, you can titrate as and what required. Sometimes you will be able to do 6 millimeters, sometimes you can just plan for 5.2. In this case, I'm trying to do a 5.2 millimeter incision, or a capsulotomy, sorry. And here, you can always four different steps of making a capsulotomy here. What is now it is a pupil. If you want to make your pupil centric and the pupil maximized, the second one is you can always make the capsulotomy in parallel to the limbus. The third one is a scanned capsule. This is the most important thing because this is a geometric capsular bag. It takes the geometric capsular bag. See, this is how, this is a geometric capsular bag, and it takes the center of the geometric capsular bag and keeps the capsulotomy centered onto that geometric capsular bag. But most of the times they'll be able to, they'll use the pupil maximized. Why? Because if I take the geometric or scanned capsule, sometimes the capsular excess margin may go behind the iris if the pupil is not very well dilated or very well centered pupil. So most of the surgeons, they prefer to use the pupil maximized or the pupil, regular pupil centric. The pupil maximized comes when the pupil is not appropriately dilated. Suppose I want to make a 5.2 millimeters of, or 5.5 millimeters of a capsulotomy diameter. But if the pupil itself is 5.5, then the system alerts me saying that the pupil is 5.5 millimeters and I cannot do a 5.5 millimeter capsulotomy in this case. then we can make it a pupil maximized, and the system gives you 1 millimeter less than whatever the pupil diameter is. So that is the beauty of the system. So you can always titrate the capsulotomy size depending on the patient's pupil and the patient's condition. And next step. The third one is the lens fragmentation. We have seven different varieties of definitions is there. You can always select whether the cataract is soft, medium, or hard. You can just feed it there. And you can, templates, there are six, seven templates are given there. You can either make only 4 quadrants or 6 quadrants or 8 octants. Just like you just make a cross and it just divides the nucleus into pieces, that's all. The second one is you can always soften each quadrant. Suppose if you are making a 4 quadrant, you can soften each quadrant with the small cubicles that makes your, that lessens your phaco energy. So that is the beauty of the femtolaser cataract assisted surgery. The reason why we want to opt for FLAX is to reduce the amount of phaco energy and the phaco time, which is detrimental to the corneal endothelium in some cases. So coming to these are the lens fragment details. You can always the horizontal spotting, vertical spotting. The most important thing is the posterior capsular safety margin. You can always fix it up where the laser firing starts from. So if the posterior capsule is, now in this case, I just kept it 750 microns from the posterior capsule safety margin. So this is the safety posterior capsule here, and my laser starts firing 750 microns anterior to the posterior capsule, so that in no way the posterior capsule is damaged because of the femto laser. As you all know, whenever the laser spot is burned there, the cavitation effect will be there up to maximum 100 microns. So here we kept a 750 micron, so the laser spot is almost 650 microns away from the posterior capsule, which is very safe zone for doing a very good femtolaser cataract as a surgery.
Sorry. Can we use this for grade 3 and grade 4 nucleus also to crack?
Yes, sir. We can use this grade 3 and grade 4. There are three, you have, if you see on the monitor, I just kept it as a soft, medium, hard, and leathery hard. In this case, it's not that hard case, it's a medium cataract. But the problem is with the hard nucleus, there are some concerns about the grade 4 nucleus, or you can say black cataracts, brown cataracts. It may not be very useful. But what happens in those cases also, I use these for some situations where I can just at least crack, I can get a crack into the nucleus fragmentation. I can just get a crack so that my chopping will be easy. It may not help me very much in a case of black cataract. I'm very honest about that. But still, if you can attempt that in a black cataract also, what happens is it creates a plane whereby the chopping is become little much easier. But that is the biggest problem during a phaco emulsification in case of a hard cataract, leathery cataracts. The leather lens fibers will not be able to crack easily with your mechanical chopping techniques. And this laser will assist you in getting a good clean cracks even in case of a 3+ or 4+ cataracts. I think I answered your question.
Thank you, sir.
And now I think the treatment plan summary is shown on the screen. Now in this case, I'm just using a 5.2 millimeters. Yes, yeah. The 5.2 millimeters, the pupil is, we call the capsulotomy template is a pupil centric. Now I kept it as a pupil centric. And the fragmentation template is a medium hot cataract. It's not a very hot cataract. The arcuate, the beauty of the other thing is you can always correct the astigmatism, corneal astigmatism also, with the help of this femto laser, up to the tune of 1.5 to 1.5 diopters of astigmatism. It will not help you much if the astigmatism is more than 2 diopters. In any way, you have to go for a toric eval. But if you have a minimal astigmatism to 1.25, 1.5, you can always correct this with the help of arcuate incision. And in this case, because it's in a spherical cornea, so I didn't use the arcuate incision template in this. And the cataract incision also, I am not using it here. Most of the surgeons, they are not using the cataract incision part of it. There are some issues, like if they have too much of an arcus, and then the laser rays may not give you the exact corneal incisions. And that too, because this is a clean room. My concern is this is not a sterile room. My laser room is only a clean room. So I don't want to do a corneal incision, a cataract incision, here in the non-sterile room. That is my concern. So that is the reason why I'm not doing a cataract incisions here in this non-sterile clean room. So that part I'm leaving it alone. And now I think first one. I want to show the little two pieces here. And this is one, the liquid optic interface. This is the beauty of this the machine. compared to all other laser machines, the liquid optic interface has got many advantages. Because most of the times, to get a OCT, so we have to indent the cornea. So whenever you indent the cornea, you see a lot of decimate folds. So this is not very, sometimes they may give erroneous results on the OCT. So what happens, in this case, this elliptic liquid optic interface called as LOI, which is a disposable, which is very expensive. That is the reason why these suggests are very expensive. But the advantage of it is not touching the cornea at all. So the whatever this, the rim is there here, is 12 millimeters or the 14 millimeters will be diameter inside. So it depends on the different eyes, I think you can use different LOIs. But it catches this sclera, perilimbal area. It will not cornea, it will not indent the cornea. And will just keep the balance of solution inside the liquid optic interface, and the liquid they will be there inside, and this entire LOA will be coupled to the what, the another cupping here, and the, the disposable lens which is fitted onto the, this is the disposable lens, and this is the LOI. The LOI will be placed on the patient's eye, and it moves on here, and it, both of them coupled together, and then it gives the excellent OCT and the laser delivery under there. Now I'm going to start the exact procedure. The first step is done. The patient is well prepared. Late chustunnan tataya, kannotti teppukandi. And this, we just kept him a little paracaine drops. I just put a little bit of paracaine so that the eye will not painful, and we didn't block it. We don't need to block it. Sometimes the initial days I used to give a block for this procedure, but after it I stopped using the block. Why? Because whenever you give a block, sometimes there will be conjunctival chemosis will be there. The conjunctival swelling will be there. Whenever there is a conjunctival swelling, the liquid optic interface which I am going to use there, it will not hold the conjunctiva properly. So now we just retract the eyelids a little bit and just keep the liquid optic interface onto the eyeball and just press it a little tight. And then I just switch the vacuum on the machine. What happens, whatever the suction ring, the 12 millimeter suction ring, it holds the conjunctiva with a little bit of vacuum, and then we slowly move this couch. And the beauty of this couch is the integrated couch with the machine. It's not a separate unit, it's integrated couch. Now I am centering my LOI. If you observe on the monitor, now you're able to see, I'm adjusting to the red ring over there. I'm just pushing the table up. The beauty of it. So now, I'm adjusting that. And then I'm capturing this. And then locking the system. And then I'm verifying the fluid. If there are a lot of air bubbles there inside, it's not done. And now the system has got an integrated integral guidance system scanning, and it's scanning the anterior chamber. The beauty of it is you can just see the cross section of the anterior segment on the OCT monitor. It's not like a flat, it's just like a cross section, just we see in our textbooks. Oh, sorry. And here if you see, the pupillary diameter is 7.3 in the minimum and the 7.3 is the maximum. Because I captured the 5.2, that's not a big deal. So now I am just moving to the entire the anterior capsule, anterior cornea, posterior cornea, anterior lens and posterior lens is all well demarcated. And I'm ready. And I'm ready. The pupil centric is okay. It's just ticked. And then I just approved it. If you see that, the 23.1 second is the entire laser time. I'm just firing that. If you see, the capsulotomy is 1.6 seconds. Just that done. The capsulotomy is done here. And if you see, the cavitation bubbles are slowly appearing. And the phaco emulsification, the laser fragmentation is being done there. And if you see, I just made a sextant, six pieces. And then each piece is again into quadrants, small cubicles. And sometimes each cubicle will be easily swallowed or easily removed. If you see, the cavitation bubbles came through the capsulorhex margin there. So that's the beauty of it. And now it's done. I'm just releasing the vacuum off. And then reducing the height of the table. substitute. And then the table is released from the machine. Oh no, the patient is ready to be shifted to the main operating room where Dr. J.K. Reddy is going to perform the rest of the procedure, the circumcision part of it. As I was telling you, the main advantage of this machine is, the femto laser machine is, it can reduce the phacoemulsification time and energy, whereby the cornea is pristine clear the next day morning. That's one advantage of it. The second advantage of it is the capsulotomy size and shape. As I was telling you, in case of a premium IOLs, the toric and the multifocal IOLs, where you want to have the exact centration of the IOL in the capsular bag, this perfect capsulotomy, near perfect capsulotomy is very good. The second thing is the size of the capsulotomy. Suppose if you are using 6 millimeter optic IOL, and if you want all around overlap of the capsular margin onto the IOL, then you can always fix it as a 5.5 or 5.75 or 5.25, the other part of it. And in case of huge black cataracts, yes, there are some limitations in this mesh technology, but only thing is it will help you to make a good capsulotomy, and then it makes a little cracks there so that your chopping will be easier. I find it very useful in hypermature cataracts, where we struggle a lot to do a capsulotomy itself. Well, we puncture the capsulotomy, entire the argentine flaxen will appear there most of the times. Even sometimes you are careful also. And the next best option is the subluxated cataracts. If you have a little subluxation, the OCT, the integral guidance system of OCT is so beautiful. I have some videos also. So beautiful, entire lens tilt it will show. And taking that lens tilt into the consideration, the system will decide where to fire the capsulotomy and where to, what is the, it takes a little subluxation also into account and gives the exact delivery of the laser energy. And that makes life easy. Suppose if there's subluxation and if you want to do a capsulotomy, sometimes the entire joint of subluxation may increase beyond your things. So in those cases, this femto laser assisted capsulotomy will really be useful in subluxated cataracts and hypermature cataracts or in very intermittent capsule where you are expecting argentine flaxen. So black cataracts, they have said there's some limitation, but still, in most of the cases, that will be very useful. And I am not incorporating at the coronary incision, but people say if you are incorporating the coronary incision is very good, very useful. But arcuate incision is really useful in case of 1 to 1.5 adapters of astigmatism, where I can just treat it with the femto laser assisted cataracts.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, just moving on to the theater now.
One doubt, sir. Dr. Gopal Kishore.
Please, sir.
Sir, you have shown your OCT picture before doing the capsulotomy and this laser break.
Sir.
Can we see the same picture after doing the capsulotomy and this nuclear fragmentation so that the depth of the crack can be seen?
No. Actually, when the first OCT itself will show you, the first OCT itself will show you the entire grid pattern.
Yeah.
I think if you see that, I kept it as 750 microns difference from the posterior capsule. So I know pretty well that my laser delivery will be in the central zone only.
Yes.
If your screen shows,
yeah.
If the screen shows the right, left, the down and right, the entire green area marked over there, that is the only area where the laser is going to be fired. So I have a 500 microns clear zone from the anterior capsule, and I have a 750 microns clear zone from the posterior capsule. So in the central area only, the lens will be fragmented with the help of the laser.
Then post-cracking, can we see the cracks, a similar picture like this? That's what...
I don't think that. Post-cracking, will not be able to see the OCT now.
Oh, yeah. We cannot see the OCT.
Yes, we cannot. Okay. But the bubbles came out, no? That itself indicates that the laser is delivered properly. The bubbles came to the posterior capsule. If you see that there's small bubbles over there, and underneath the anterior capsule, that itself shows that the laser is delivered. Yes. This picture will get it, that's all. The picture will change on the monitor. Yeah. The completion of laser treatment, that's the end point of it, that shows on my monitor here. And if you see the 6 quadrants and then small cubicles and some amount of air bubbles is the anterior chamber. Yeah, move out to the operating room.